Good evening, folks. This is Mark from Southern Tier WordPress Training. And in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about a plugin that I think is fantastic. And it's a plugin that allows you to have, if you want, a custom header for every page or every blog post or every archive page of your WordPress Power website. Now, as you probably know, that's functionality that doesn't come standard with most WordPress themes. It's something that you might see in a premium theme, but not usually in a free theme. So I'm going to show you how to use this plugin, and again, it's called WP Display Header. You can either download it here and then re-upload it via FTP, or you can install the plugin right from the dashboard, right from the back end of your WordPress website, and I actually have a tutorial on how to install WordPress plugins if you don't already know how to do that. So continuing on here, I'm going to get logged into my website, and I just want to make note, I've already installed the plugin. I'll just show you real quick. I'm going to go over to plugins, install plugins, and here is my WP Display Header plugin. You can see that it's activated. And another thing that I've already done is I've already uploaded the headers that I'm going to use for the purposes of this demonstration. Generally, to get to the area of your theme where you'll upload headers or custom headers, you'll go under Appearance and Header. And you'll see that I have 4 custom headers already pre-installed. Okay, so I'm going to make an assumption here that if you're interested in this type of a plugin in the first place, that the blog or the website that you are working on creating needs to have a semi-professional look anyway. Otherwise, you wouldn't care and you would just use the same header all the way across the entire website. So that being said, I always, when I'm designing headers for my website, I'll go even before I add any content to the website. If I know that I'm going to have custom headers or even a singular custom header, I'll go into this back into my website and I'll look at what the suggested size is. So in this case, the suggested width is 960 pixels and the suggested height is 250 pixels. And then I'll go ahead and I'll open up Photoshop and then I'll design my header right within those specifications. That way I know when I upload my photos that I'm going to use, there's not going to be any kind of strange cropping that I'll have to do where I'll be forced to, for example, you know, if this particular image that I'm showing you right now, if it were too tall, I might be forced to lose, you know, some of the phone number here, maybe part of the address. That's not something that you want to deal with. It's silly. So just keep that in mind. Go ahead and find out what the size of the header the theme allows you to have is. Make it as big as you can, but still make it fit within those dimensions and design your headers that way. Just a little side note there. So that being said, I already have 4 images that I've uploaded. 1, 2, 3, 4. They look very similar, but there's some yellow text there that differentiates them for me. They don't need to be that different because these headers were simply created for the purposes of demonstrating this plugin for a video, so they look very similar. I've also gone ahead and I've installed the plugin itself. And here it is right over here, WP Display Header. And again, if you don't know how to install plugins, if you're fairly new to WordPress, just check out my tutorial on how to install plugins. But that being said, we have all the ingredients that we need to have a custom header on every single one of our pages or posts. So let's move on with this. Since the website that I'm demonstrating this plugin on doesn't have a blog, I'm simply going to show you how to have the custom header on a page. So we're going to jump up to one of my pages, or rather we're going to jump up to all pages. I'm just going to pick a page at random here. Let's pick the About Us page. I'm going to click Edit, and as you can see, this right here is the area that plugin added for us. and it gives us a thumbnail image of all of the headers that we've uploaded that are available for us to use for this page. So we just choose based on the radio button, and I'm going to choose this one. I don't know if you can see, but down here in the lower right, it actually says for demonstration with a number 3. So I am going to choose that, and I'm going to update the page, and I'm going to view the page, jump over here to About Us, and there you go. As you can see, it says for demonstration 3, and just to be thorough, I'll go back, choose this one instead, this first one. It actually looks much different than the other ones. As you can see, there's a picture of a building over here to the left. So again, I'm going to go ahead and hit update. I'm going to jump back out to the website and refresh. And there you have it. Custom headers on every or any page of your WordPress powered website. Simple, beautiful, elegant. Again, this is a fantastic plugin. It's today's date is September 10th, 2013. And the most current version of website as we speak is 3.6. And this plugin is compatible up to version 3.6. So you know the people are doing their work on the back end. I'd feel completely safe installing this plugin. And have a lot of fun with it. You can create some beautiful, beautiful websites using this plugin. So have a great day, folks. I hope this was helpful. If you have any comments or questions or suggestions, please leave them below. And be sure to like my video and subscribe to my channel for more WordPress tutorials happening all the time. Thanks very much. Have a great one.